On the 4th of September, we honor St. Rose of Viterbo, who spent her brief life as a recluse and who was outspoken in her support of the papacy. Otherwise leading an unremarkable life, she later became known for her mystical gifts of prophecy and having miraculous powers. Born in 1235 at Viterbo, in the domains of the Papal States, Rose was gifted with a profound spirituality even as a young child. Endowed by God with the gift of miracles, at the age of 3 she raised her maternal aunt to life. Her great love for the poor compelled her to assist them in every possible way. From her earliest years, she gave herself over to prayer and penance for the conversion of sinners, and at 7 she retired to a little cell within her parents' home. Rose's health succumbed under the severe penances she imposed upon herself, and the following year she fell gravely ill. During her illness, Our Lady appeared to her in a dream and cured her. She was instructed by the Mother of God to be clothed in the habit of Saint Francis as a tertiary, but to remain at home and be an example to her neighbors. At this particular time, the city of Viterbo was occupied by the twice excommunicated emperor, Frederick II. Frederick was at war with the papacy and had sworn to conquer all of the papal states. Inspired by divine providence, Rose would issue forth from her seclusion and preach in the streets and public squares of her city. With the crucifix in her hand, the young missionary would describe for the growing crowds the sufferings of our Lord during his passion, thereby showing them the heinousness of sin. With deep concern, she exhorted them to repent of their sins and to convert. Urging them to be faithful to the authority of the Pope, Rose likewise admonished those who yielded to the emperor. Before long, crowds began to gather in the vicinity of her home, hoping for a glimpse of her. When her father, frightened by all the attention his daughter attracted, forbade her to even leave the house to preach under pain of physical punishment, the local parish priest intervened and convinced him to withdraw his prohibition. For 2 years, the child Franciscan preached conversion to her fellow citizens. Her ardent words were often accompanied by prodigies that stunned the crowds. The stone on which she stood to speak, for example, was seen to rise up off the ground and sustain her in mid-air during her preaching. While the general population was moved to conversion and penance by her words and example, the partisans of the emperor were incensed against the young preacher and actively clamored for her death. The civil authorities, however, while they were alarmed by her public exhortations, they would not go so far as to condemn a mere child to death, and instead exiled her and her parents from Viterbo. In January 1250, they took refuge first in Soriano, where on December 5th of the same year, Rose prophesied the imminent death of the emperor. A prediction came to pass on December 13th, and soon after, Pope Innocent IV regained control of the papal states through a stipulation in the emperor's own will, which directed that all lands he had taken from the church be returned. Soon afterwards, Rose and her parents went to Viterchiano. A sorceress there had greatly influenced the citizens of this hillside town, and the young apostle set about her public preaching once more. Her exhortations moved the people, but failed with the sorceress herself. Undaunted, Rose had an immense wooden pyre built in the public square and climbed to the top. She had it set on fire. For 3 hours she stood unscathed in the midst of the devouring flames, singing the praises of God. Sincerely moved by the miracle, the repentant sorceress fell to her knees. With the restoration of the papal authority in Viterbo in 1251, Rose and her parents returned to their native city. She sought admittance to the poor clares at the monastery of St. Mary of the Roses, but was turned away for lack of a dowry. Humbly submitting to this decision, she foretold her admission to the convent after her death. A mere 15 years of age, Her subsequent attempts to establish a religious community near the monastery with the help of her parish priest proved equally disappointing. She therefore retired once more to a cell in her family home, where she died 2 years later on March 6, 1252. She was first buried in the church of Santa Maria in Podio and later in the church of the monastery where she had once requested admission. Her last prophecy was fulfilled on September 4, 1258, but the many miracles attributed to her intercession continue to this day. Not least among the numerous favors granted to Saint Rose of Viterbo by Almighty God is the ongoing incorrupt preservation of her body. As recently as 2010, scientific research on her incorrupt body revealed that she had died of a rare heart condition known as Cantrell syndrome and not of tuberculosis as had been previously thought. Placing all our petitions before her today, let us pray. Hear us, God our Saviour, that as we rejoice in commemorating the Virgin Blessed Rose, we may be instructed by her loving devotion. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God for ever and ever. Amen.